What's going on, everybody? James is back again to bring you another video of the spoilers that we're going to be getting tomorrow. Obviously, these spoilers are going to be earlier from this point on, which is cool because I'm going to get back into the swing of things. PC is finally here, so we're ready to go. Anyway, enough of that. Episode 30 of Bleach is here. What is the name of this one? It's called The Betrayer, and this is essentially going to be Ichigo versus Uryu. So before we get into the synopsis and the pictures, hit that like, that subscribe, and all that good stuff. That being said, let's get into it, shall we? Right, so as I said, this is clearly an Ichigo versus Uryu episode with some nice little surprises. Word on the street, again, because you can't fully not get spoiled. And it's going to be 12 episodes of new content. And to be honest with you, we've been getting new content almost every single episode. So I mean, like, it's not even surprising at this point. It's almost just like a cool fucking thing that just continuously happens. And I'm glad that it's not surprising anymore. I'm glad that it's not a surprising thing. So let's get into this synopsis, shall we? And then we'll break it down, look at the images, etc, etc. Ukotake releases the power of the Mimihagi-sama that resides in his body and becomes the Mimihagi itself and stops the collapses of the world on behalf of the Spirit King, who was killed by Yuaba. The Mimihagi itself tries to wipe out the Soul King. I feel like that's a mistranslation, but whatever, we'll roll with it. Ichigo and the others confront Yuaba in an attempt to stop him, but they are met with arrows from Uryu. Ichigo questions the true meaning of Uryu's actions, but Uryu replies with empty words and strong hostility. So, yeah, I mean, pretty much how the manga goes, essentially. Again, I haven't read this section for a while because I want to come into the Thousand Year Blood War with a fresh mind and a fresh output on things. So we already knew that Ichigo versus Uryu was going to happen at some point, but when we get into the screenshots that you're going to see right now, things start getting interesting. So first and foremost, we have, obviously, Ichigo versus Uryu. Again, nothing to go on with this image. Obviously, we see a hole in the background. Obviously, Uryu probably made his appearance, but Ichigo is close enough to Uryu to give him a collar grab and probably saying like, what the fuck are you doing? You know, what's going on? We already know that there's a little bit of a fight going on because the next image we get to see, the image from the trailer of that nice little Sakuga moment of Uryu throwing some arrows. And yeah, like this is a very nice, actually, can I see the staff right quick? Is there anyone noticeable? Cindy? Love Cindy. She's great. Katsubara? Yeah, okay. So I'm liking this episode. This episode seems to have a good, respectable team on. Uryu, Ichigo fight going down. Next one we see Yuaba looking at the Soul King with the Mimihagi hand, and it has that kind of interesting flashback. Not the flashback, but the grain or the texture or the transition that it does when Yuha's trying to look into or using his almighty ability. I'll just say that. And it seems like he is looking menacing. He seems pissed off. This is probably, I'm going to take a guess and say that this is probably where he's probably going to go reach out for the hand and probably try and absorb it. People are really confused of the idea too, but people seem to be really of the misunderstanding of like people saying, oh, why can't Yuha foresee the Soul King? Well, because the Soul King is literally more powerful than Yuha, right? Just because you have a broken ability, as Aizen said, and I'm dumbing it down, like I'm really dumbing it down to not get over complicated with things, but you know, remember when Aizen said battles are about who has the highest spiritual pressure. And, you know, clearly the Soul King, the Rayo, has higher spiritual pressure. Obviously, he couldn't be defeated by Yuha alone. He needed Ichigo. So, obviously, there's just going to be some things that Yuha isn't going to anticipate or essentially block Yuha's vision. And that makes sense. Absolutely makes sense. Because, again, the Soul King is just beyond reason. And Yuha is still within the art of reason, so to say. So it's not, to me, it's not that complicated. Obviously, I can't explain it that well. But the best screenshot. The best screenshot. Do you know what? I'm going to leave it till last. We have this one of Ichigo holding his sword. Looks cool. That's all I'm going to say. It just looks cool. There's nothing I can talk about here. Let's talk about the best screenshot. Do you know what's funny about this? I mean, fuck Ganju right off the bat. If he does something, then I'll be surprised. But Chad with the battle stands. And I love Orihime. She's trying her best. Her arms are up like she's about to throw down. You know she ain't going to do shit besides Sun Tenkeshun. But do you know what I fucks with Orihime because she's just a nice little sweet cinnamon roll that you just can't imagine getting angry and getting into a fight. She's amazing. She's absolutely fucking cool. So I love that shot. Whoever drew that shot, kudos to you. I don't know if she's pouting or if it's just like a bit of a janky, not janky, I wouldn't say janky, because it's not janky up, but like it's not on model that much, but I don't know if it's purposeful. She looks a bit like chibi-ish-fied or like pouty-fied, I don't know, but again, great image here nonetheless. So again, I have heard things, I'm not going to dabble them into this video too much, besides the fact that, again, Twitter just doesn't know when to shut the fuck up, or people don't know when to stop spreading leaks from certain individuals. But I heard that they do get into Ichigo's groups, does get into singular fights, I believe, but I don't know much more than that, and I'm excited if that is the case to see, again, Chad, Gonju, and Orihime actually doing something this fucking war. Because in the manga, do you know what Chad does? For those that don't know, he just fought sand puppets. So to see Chad do something, holy fuck, Kubo, you're slapped. But with that being said, I'm gonna catch you, motherfuckers. Like, you guys, of course, have this fine day. I've been Hansen, as always, people. Peace out.